Hello and welcome to Skip Ace Fantasy Disc Golf Podcast, your choice for the best, but mostly the worst, disc golf picks on the internet. I'm the host and site creator, John Van Derzen. Last week I said I try to pick a band from the state that we're in, but I couldn't honestly find a good band from Arkansas that I like. So I thought about doing Mr. Jones, but instead it's Warrant with Heaven Isn't Too Far Away. And I use that because we're going to the disc side of heaven, and it is getting closer every day. Welcome to episode 5. I'm going to recap my picks for the Champions Cup real quick, even though I probably shouldn't. And after taking my lashings for that, I'll be back on the horse and make some predictions for Jonesboro. So as a reminder, my picks for the Champions Cup mostly stunk it up. My MPO must-have pick of the event was Paul McBeth. It was a major. And even though it was a little risky, because Paul's rated so high, I thought it was a surefire bet. He ended up finishing tied for 20th with actually two other Pauls. And my risky pick of the event was Gavin Babcock. And Gavin was looking really, really good up until his last round when he shot a 69. It dropped him all the way down to 57th. Otherwise, he was in the top 30. If you look at my must-have FPO picks, it was Sarah Hokum. She was kind of my lock for the event. And my riskier pick was Luque. Now, Hokum finished in 8th place. She performed right about where her rating was, so really no harm. But Luque ended up pulling out of the event and DNF'd. I don't exactly know, but she honestly wasn't performing well when she dropped out. So we hope there's not any sort of injury going on, but she only finished 2 of the rounds and then withdrew. So that's a big fat failure. I told you this week to avoid a few players, Anthony Barella and Emerson Keith. And early on, it was looking like AB was going to really, really make me look dumb because he was in the top 3. But he ended up falling down to 13th, below where his rating actually placed him. So, not too great, but not too bad. Emerson Keithy, on the other hand, I hope you listened to me and avoided him like the plague. Because he ended up finishing 71st place. And he didn't win anybody anything this week, poor guy. And my avoidance picks for FPO were Holland Hanley. Whoops. I don't even think I had another one. I was so sure on Holland. Holland ended up tied for 6th. And honestly, she was in 2nd place for the longest time. So if you ended up ignoring me and you picked her, you probably weren't too upset about that. Congratulations to Holland Hanley on a great weekend. Nobody was catching Kristen Tatar this weekend, but Holland was in position to have that, what would we call it, the second place that feels like a first place. But again, no one was catching Tatar. All right, let's talk about Jonesboro for a little bit. Jonesboro is the upcoming event this weekend. It's a Friday, Saturday, Sunday event. It is a longer course with a few more open fairways. It's much more open than we just saw at Champions Cup. But it's also a power thrower's course. In the past 7 years, this event has been really dominated by 3 players. Paul, Ricky, and most recently, Calvin. So, here are my must-have picks for MPO and FPO. For MPO, it's Vinny. And for FPO, it's Kristen Tatar. Those are just lock picks. Vinny's been playing really well. He didn't perform well at the major, but that's kind of Vinny's thing lately. And Tatar is on a roll. Vinny has been really comfortable at the disc side of heaven. He's won this 2 of the last 3 years. It's a course, like I said, that really sets up for him and most power players. So he's going to be kind of my lock of the week, and Tatar is just a no-brainer. My riskier picks, on the other hand, in MPO, is Ezra Aderhold. Now, he's not that risky of a pick. He's a 1032 rated player, but ultimately, Ezra has performed very well and has a really good season going on. He did not get into Champions Cup, so he's going to be well-rested. And he's just had a hot start to the season that I could really see continuing into Jonesboro the way this course lays out. The FPO risky pick I have is Stacy Ronsley. Stacy's kind of riding a hot hand right now. Last year, she finished 12th here, so I expect her to kind of be up in that top 15 with potential to be maybe 8th to 10th place. You want to talk about some players to avoid this week at Jonesboro. Over on the MPO side, and I know, sit down, this might sound a little crazy, but I'm going to avoid Isaac Robinson. He just won at Champions Cup. I think we should maybe expect a little come down week after this huge win at the major. On top of all of that, he isn't exactly known for his distance. He's no slouch, but at this course, it really comes down to a power player on the MPO side. You need to be able to really throw those long distance shots, and I don't think that Isaac has it. The only way Isaac keeps up is if he's like 95% inside that circle. The FPO player to avoid, this was a little bit tougher, but I ended up going with Jessica Weiss. Again, I just don't see her distance easily overcome. Her upside is, though, that she throws from both sides of the pad, and that could help her out on some of these holes, especially when you get towards the green. There's a stretch of them in the middle that all bend towards a right-hand forehand shot. Let's talk a little bit about draft leagues. Waiver wire for MPO. And again, these are players that are rostered in less than 65% of the leagues out there who might be available. And if you listened to me last week, you picked up Yuna Hanninen. He finished 13th at the Champions Cup. Yuna is only owned in about 46% of leagues, so it's not too late to get him still. But let's look at a different MPO pick, because I picked Yuna last week. So let's try to mix it up a little bit. Austin Turner. Austin Turner is only owned in 25% of leagues right now. He is a far-throwing lefty and a player who is really suddenly playing well above his current ownership level. I think Austin should be owned in more closer to 60% of the leagues right now. Austin's only problem is on the green. His putt can kind of come and go, but over the last few weeks, it looks really good. And I think Jonesboro could be a great event for a power thrower like him. And over on the FPO waiver wire, I said her name earlier. I'm going to say it again, Stacy Ronsley. She's only owned in 23% of leagues right now. If you're not confident in your FPO picks or your bench spots, maybe you're sitting with someone like Rebecca Cox, who you're probably not going to play, or Paige Hsu, who you're not confident in. Stacy's a great option this week. And she's performed well here in the past, so I don't see why she can't continue to play well this year, and yet, of course, she's performed well in the past. If you want to see the data that I've accumulated over the last 4 years, I pulled in all the results for the last 4 years, averaged them out, took a look at ratings. I put that out on skipace.com/JonesPast. And this is the exclusive place that I give for that research information. I don't really put it anywhere else. Some other notes. Last week, I was really excited because I said, Ricky is back. And then he's not. He withdrew from the Champions Cup at the last minute. So Ricky is not back. But you know who might be coming back? And I'm not sure if he's going to make it into town this week. Linus Karlsson. Linus got his sports visa. He posted it on social media yesterday or today. And I assume he's going to get his stuff all organized and fly over. He's on the registration list. I don't think I would probably put him in my lineups quite this week, but he is on his way over. So if you're listening to this and he's out there on your waiver wire, grab him right now. And I want to thank this week's sponsor for our Jonesboro Pro Skip Base Challenge. It's Disc Golf Stream. Disc Golf Stream is giving away a free subscription to their Disc Golf streaming service. You can find all of the EPT events, those are the European Pro Tour events, that have the best European events, the best European players, and some of the most gorgeous courses in the world. So if you're not a Skip Base Pro subscriber, pay the $10, enter in the challenge. or just go to discstream.com and sign up and watch all the best European events for the rest of the season. Thanks a lot to Disc Golf Stream.